It's not panto season yet. Come on. Good evening, everybody. Hello. Right. My name's... I should do this properly. Lord Mayor, when he gets here. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues. My name's Mike Weld. I'm the Chief Exec of MAC. And it's my very, very great honour and pleasure to welcome you to the 2016 Spirit of Manchester Awards. You're going to be doing a lot, and under the Health and Safety Act 1974, we're required to give you training on how to do clapping. So if we can just get, here is an example of clapping. You can choose to embellish that if you wish. I would advise that you don't go as far as this. That man is not doing clapping properly. So hands like this, right? Now, this side of the room. Start putting your hands together very slowly, faster, and louder. And you've got to get as loud as you possibly can, right? And start cheering, making some noise. You just start clapping slowly, and see if you can raise as much noise as they just did, and there's less of you on this side. Right, keep going, keep going. It's charming, so even you guys. This is going to be a wonderful night. It's really great to see so many of you out here to support our city's fantastic volunteer community sector. I'm very proud of you all for being rebels and coming out on a school night. That's fantastic. I know a lot of you is, please enjoy this evening. This is a rare night for us in our sector. This is a time when we just celebrate the fact of how good we are. As I say, I might well than the Chief Exec of MAC, and my job is to make more good things happen in this city. For those of you, we're a civic institution, if you like, that supports and develops the voluntary community organisations. There are over 3,000 of them in the city of Manchester alone. MAC helps set up new groups, helps develop existing groups, and generally try and get the sector doing its best in local communities, because we believe at the heart the voluntary sector is a tremendous force for good. We also help in other ways, building partnerships. Part of the whole reason for us doing this tonight is for you to meet each other and get to know some people maybe you didn't know before. It is not random necessarily where you're sitting. We have tried to pair people up a little bit, and there has been a matchmaking exercise that is quite simply to make more good stuff happen, make more wonderful things happen. I also get to do the boring stuff about housekeeping. So, if there is a fire, and we're not expecting one, so you just proceed to your nearest one and follow the green signs that will direct you. The toilets, if you need them, are out that way. There's ladies, gents, and disability access toilet over there as well. If you do need to take a comfort break during the night, just go to get through. However, you will be required to buy raffle tickets in order to get back into your seat. I'm warning you now. We have people posted, stationed, armed with raffle tickets. Photographs. We're delighted to welcome Tom Hopkins, who's taken photographs for us this evening. Please let them know, or let a member of the MAC team know. It's impossible in a room like this to avoid capturing you by accident, but we will make sure that any photos of you aren't used if you don't want us to. I can also do quite a reasonable rate in photos to fund. We're also delighted to have, there she is, Mirella Village from That's Manchester TV, is capturing some footage of the event. She's going to be doing some interviews with our winners, once we know who they are. And we are, about a minute and a half, going around Manchester, once all the viewers catch up with us. And this year we are webcasting with the sound turned on. That's brilliant, because last year it was just silence. So, phones. Please turn your phone to silent, but if you spend some time looking at your phone this evening, we want you to, because if you're on any form of social media, we want you to share this event. The hashtag is SpiritOfManchester16, and it's the voluntary sector's marketing and communications team tonight. I know this is a party, but you're going to work. So, what we want you to do is help spread the word if you want to share the news of what you're seeing tonight, because this is part of the purpose of it, is to tell people about the amazing voluntary sector we have in the city. There is over there, there is a Twitter wall, which is, we're already trending on Twitter, before we'd even started. So that's a record for us, which I'm really pleased about. There is another reason why I want you to keep your phone on, and I'll tell you about that in a minute. We're going to be still coming in from the car because they've been queuing. I'll try and race through as fast as we can. This is the fourth year of the Spirit of Manchester Awards. Once again, it's got bigger. It's now a programme that Mac runs through. Co-op, yeah, one or two, yeah. You might remember, then it was just a one-night awards thing, that was it. Now, it runs throughout the year. It's a festival. We've had over 70... This year we've added a thing called Spirit Story, which is capturing examples of things, sort of crystallography, spiritualist stuff that's slammed together and we celebrate. I think all of us at Mac, we can't imagine not doing this now. It's in the city's calendar that we spend some time celebrating the amazing work of all the thousands of volunteers. And because of people like you, supporters, people who've either... I'll be telling you details about all of those as we go along. Please do take a look in the brochure, which has... We've tried to strike a very careful balance this evening. This is a beautiful venue. I think you'll agree the food was fantastic, beautifully laid out, and a huge thanks to the chefs. There are people in communities up and down this city who would struggle to get to something like that. We strike a very careful tone because we know that one of the biggest growth industries in our sector is food banks and anti-poverty campaigns. This is not a black tie dinner, this is a party. And I want you to enjoy it as a party, even though you're going to be working and talking about some interesting things that you'll see in some of the videos. But that's why this is about all of those causes deserving some time to celebrate the people who work in them. But we recognise that tomorrow we've got to go back to work. So, I said you're going to need your phone. The observant ones amongst you might have seen you've got little cards in the shape of a phone, there's a clue there, on your tablet. But one of the things we've also introduced into this programme is the Spirit of Manchester Fund. And earlier this year we gave out our very first mini-grant from money we raised at last year's event. And that went to things like North Manchester Black Health Forum, there was a project at the Irish Heritage Centre with the Manchester Jewish Museum, some fantastic examples of collaboration. We want to raise more to be able to give more out, so you will see that you can donate by text by giving £3, £5, or £10 if you text MANC03 and then £3, £5, or £10 to 70070. That will be very much appreciated. There are also, which you may well have already been accosted, please, please do buy plenty. They're just £1 each. You get to win some of these amazing raffle prizes. If you've not done your first fiver yet, this is a very good way to use that. You can do any charity in Greater Manchester with it, but we would really encourage you to invest in the Spirit of Manchester Fund. We've got about 20 prizes here. I reckon they're worth at least £500. So that's your target to beat. I want to see, please, please, do try and spend on the raffle tickets, because it would be a shame if we don't sell those for at least their face value in raffle tickets. That's going to enable us to do so much more work with community groups. I've said there are members of the staff team. There is actually a competition going on. And it's my duty to tell you. We have Alison leading one team and Pauline leading the other, and they are in a fight to see who can sell the most raffle tickets. It might interest you to know that Pauline knows some people who know some people. Let's just leave it at that. So please, please buy some raffle tickets. It's for your own good. So we have a Manchester City starter kit and some boxing gloves which have been signed by Anton Crawler. So I know I'm talking about money, and that's something that the voluntary sector has to do. We would far rather talk to you about why we have a bit of money to give to some small community groups, and Mac will not take one penny of the money that we raise tonight. Now, the best bit of this is when the Lord Mayor turns up. And this is the point where I was expecting he might be here by now. So, I am going to... 10 minutes. Oh, that's good. Now, do I try and give us an impromptu speech for 10 minutes? I think what I'll do is we'll do the first category. So, test question.
Right. This is where the script goes down, shall we?
Right. So, what I'll do is tell you about the process. Sorry, it's me talking. We ran a nomination process, and that was an invitation to people all over Manchester to send us examples of fantastic work by volunteer community organisations in the city, in response to the categories that MAC chose. That's the only bit of this process that we control. We pick the categories, and we pick those categories to highlight things that we think are really good about the sector, or that our sector should be really good at. Things like volunteering, supporting volunteers, all the categories that you can see in the brochure, because we want to encourage those. Now, in the first couple of years for this, this is the fourth year, the first couple of years we got about 70 nominations. This year, we passed 130. So this is growing every year, and I'm really, really pleased about that. So never fail to be staggered by the wealth and diversity of the nominations that we're getting. So first thank you of the evening really is thank you to everybody who sent in a nomination. It's the stories that we get to read in that is amazing, and once tonight's over we'll be thinking about starting the next wave of nominations in the new year. We then put together a panel of independent judges. Again, Max not on the judging panel. And they give their time to read through the nomination forms and produce the shortlist of the people you're going to meet tonight. So before we go any further, I'd like to thank the judges. So Atiya Chowdhury from Manchester BME Network, Lisa Godrey from the University of Manchester, Graham Hughes from Grattan's LOP, Eleanor Watts from Riverside Group, and the chair of the judging panel, Claire Evans from 4CT. Huge thanks to them. That is a big, big job, and it gets bigger every year, so really, very much appreciated. As I say, Max not on the panel. We have no part in that process whatsoever, and we don't make the decisions about who wins, because you're going to do that tonight. That's your job. Each of the individuals tonight that you're going to see has had a short film made about them, which we're going to show you. Now, what that means is, if you do the maths, we've had to make over 30 films. For this evening, and that's an advantage to us because we're part of a thing called the Community Reporters Network, and at this point I was going to point to Gary Coppedge, who should be sitting there, and he's not here. But People's Voice Media run a thing called the Institute of Community Reporters, and we run that in Manchester. This year we did something slightly different. We used a huge range of people, but we also offered the groups who've been shortlisted the opportunity to be trained and make their own film. So the people I want to thank there are PC Christina Hush and Summer, Taniola Dowie, Daryl Flanagan, Chloe Spencer, Saira Mirza, Joanne Wilcox, Rosie Khan Wright, Bridget McCann, Paulie Lazoy Hocking, and Adnan from Awaz. So can we just have a round of applause for them? We also have some of our existing community reporters, so huge thanks to them for volunteering their time. That's Terry Scragg, Mike Bradbury, and Tina Rhiannon. And we also had a huge input from MAC staff, particularly Hannah, Hugh, and especially Barkery and Jack. So where are you guys? Yep, there's Jack and Mark, so we are. Thank you. We had some fantastic extra help from O2. Telefonica. I want to thank Laura Mullen at Telefonica UK because they gave us some support in working with people to edit the films. That was a huge, huge piece of work for us every year, making sure everything's edited. So it's really great to have formed that partnership. And I also want to thank somebody who's not here tonight, which is a real shame to us. We had a film student, a guy called James Street, who talked about us because he kind of joined the team for a couple of weeks. Everybody who contributed to making the films that you'll see tonight. Now, here's how the process acts. Then we have a look at the films, and then you'll use them often. We'll calculate the results of the voting and announce the winner. I can tell you neither of them have worked for either the FA or FIFA, so you can trust the results. This is going to be fun. At different times, often on little phones and camcorders and things like that, these are not intended to be, you know, Oscar-winning things like that. When you cast your vote, the thing I want you to think about is the story that sings to you most. The one that you're going to want to leave telling other people about, because that's the one that we need to highlight. So please, please, don't just think about the quality of the films, focus on the story that you're going to hear. You will hear some incredible stories tonight. The voting itself, you have handsets on your tables. They are tied down with string, because if they go missing, we have to replace them, and there are tags on them and everything. The reason that there are not enough of them is because we're the voluntary sector, and we encourage people to share. It's also we just don't have enough. But there is one between two. So when we do the voting, you're going to vote in shifts. You'll need to take it in turns and decide who gets to vote first, and then you pass it on to the person next to you, right? You're all grown ups, you can all work this out. That's fantastic. It works, believe me. It might sound complicated, but it works. Self-determination is a key principle of the voluntary sector. Now, incidentally, the voting system is available for hire at very reasonable rates, and please see Martin afterwards if you're interested. Now, when we come to vote, I'll tell you which button to press for which candidate, and you'll have 10 seconds. Now, it doesn't sound like very much, but believe me, it's plenty of time just to go plonk on a number. The reason that we do it fairly quickly is because when we've done this in the past, we used to leave 30 seconds or 20 seconds, and people would sit there like, how long does it take me to press the button? So it's 10 seconds and it keeps us moving fast. It's a lot simpler than it sounds. It'll make sense when you try it. We are going to try a test question. There's a test question coming up. We'll do that first. Yeah. And I just want to stop because our guest of honour has arrived. Ladies and gentlemen, can I please ask you to give a big round of applause and a huge welcome for Carl Osterby and the Lord Mayor of Manchester.
Outside the Palace Hotel and has managed to block the whole of Oxford Street off. So I think there's going to be a few bit of the spirit of Manchester Awards. Manchester's international reputation is built on the history of industry, creativity and civic action. It's not just by chance that we have a diverse and spirit of Manchester is about celebrating the social action taking place in communities all around us. There are other places the city's achievements are celebrated, but this is the social enterprises sector. The voluntary and community sector plays such a key part in the makeup of this great city, and it's only right that we should spend at least one evening with organisations, many of whom are here this evening. City, working alongside 12,400 paid staff. MAC increased in the last few years. This is one of the indicators of the new Our Manchester taking. From the smallest peer group, but helping neighbours to feel less isolated and for the most vulnerable members of our community. Without the work of the communities these groups make to running, it's not just about meeting the needs and providing support. It's about Manchester being a living, making Manchester a great place to work and do, as well as the physical fabric of the city, transport, buildings, etc. Heritage groups looking after buildings, childcare and play facilities, culture events, sports and music. That's why hundreds of volunteers and paid staff who work so hard in support of local groups and good causes should be applauded and recognised. They really are an essential rent ingredient to the life and the prosperity to build and develop the success of the city. Shared by everyone who lives, works and studies here, so I challenge large corporations and small local businesses to think about they can work to increase their role in supporting the. So I am proud to be associated with the Spirit of Manchester Awards. My thanks to Matt for organising this opportunity.
This evening, taking time out of, I know, also a tremendously busy schedule. I just want to take a moment to pay particular attention, which we'll all know about, but in amongst all of that, isn't it wonderful that Manchester finally has an openly gay Lord Mayor? Yeah. And the very first thing he did was now straight, he didn't even take his bling off, but he went straight to the LGBT Foundation and helped out at an event. That meant so much to us in the voluntary sector to see the Lord Mayor doing that. straight away. So whether it's the videos of him dancing at the Mela or the leading Pride march with those wonderful pink robes on, it's just been a huge, huge uplift to us all. So I just wanted to say thank you. We don't often get to smile at some of the things that are going on in the world at the moment, but that may certainly cheer me up sometimes. So thank you very much for that. Now, we're going to do the test question now. You ready? Okay, the technical team are ready, so this is going to work. No pressure. Right. I've got to get back to the right page. So, you will see on your tables you've got the voting buttons. We're going to give you a question to try them out with, so you can practice the voting. Now, today's the 6th of October. And on this day, a very, very famous book was published in 1847. And the author, you might not know, first came up with the idea for the story of this book while staying in Manchester, just near the university, where the Salutation is. There's a blue plaque commemorating this, if you know the Salutation on Boundary Street West. So, can you identify the book and the author? So, using your voting buttons, you're going to press 1 if you think it was Pride and Prejudice and Jane Austen. Press 2 if you think it was Jane Eyre and Charlotte Bronte. Or press 3 if you think, what do you think was the book published on this day in 1847? If you're voting first, 10 seconds. On to your neighbours if they've not voted yet, and you're going to have again 10 seconds to vote starting now. Okay. Are the results in? Okay. Right. Well, this is clearly, I said you were a very intelligent audience. The correct answer was Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. She was staying in Manchester while her dad was having his eyes tested. You clearly have more humour than intelligence. That's good. So, you can see how the voting system's going to work. It's going to be fairly quick. We'll just rattle through it. But the winner is a very, very simple. Who gets the most votes? We add all the rounds up, it works. You know, it's a simple majority. Right? It's not like we're changing the constitution or voting ourselves out of an international agreement or anything. Before, we're being webcast. There are lots of nominees here tonight. So I need to make sure that your audience appreciation skills are at peak performance because we're about to start giving out awards. So, we've tested you for sound. And I want you to do some more clapping, please. So we'll start this side this time. So I'm getting going very, very slowly and build it up and up and more noise. Can you rock at the back? Think about more, right. Now, you've got to hit that every single time. By the way, this isn't the Oscars. There are going to be no. First category is volunteer. A few years ago, as the Lord Mayor's just mentioned, we ran a piece of research called State of the Sector. It's running again now. Please fill it in. Please, it's so important. 1,000 people in Manchester who give their time voluntarily every year, it is, in some capacity. And I think it's probably even more than that. Hopefully we'll find out. See heroes. Can I invite to the stage Oliver Bradley? And can I invite
I expected him to stay for about the first few weeks. He said, actually, I really like it, I would like to stay. So since then, over about the last 2 years, a classic example is we've been running a breakfast club this holiday as well. So for a teenager to want to get up and be here for 8:30 in the morning, advise everyone to have a go and carry on. Oliver's been a really positive influence on bad press, but actually, Oliver's really personable, he's funny, he's friendly, but also very sensitive. And I've really watched how young people actually care about other people's situations.
Which aims to raise awareness of the fact that homeless women can't access sanitary products. Joe's made a massive impact on the lives of the adults and young people that she works with. Three times a month, there's a permanent donation bin stationed in the foyer of the Students' Union, which means that people can be donating dietary products for homeless women at any point in which they'll be distributed.
She volunteers for the Stroke Association, goes above and beyond her role in so many ways. She's the message of the Stroke Association when she's out doing events, talking to corporates, talking to groups, don't even ask for what she'll see, you know, that needs doing. And she's always on the lookout for other volunteers. Dance for Fine Art and Unity at prestigious events. It's so nice to show a community to carers. And her time is so amazingly precious. And we
do so many different roles within the group. Unite for Change is led by the members who are asylum seekers. And people seeking asylum have lots of different issues that they want to raise and campaign about, but often have difficulty either being the voice for themselves or interpreting for themselves into English. So Diane speaks many languages and she'll interpretate for people, whether that's in conferences or in the meeting itself, on a one-to-one basis. She goes to people's meetings with them, she'll support them with their confidence as well. Diane has motivated lots of the members. A lot of people have said to Diane, or said to me separately, that Diane is always positive, and that's a quite difficult thing when you're seeking asylum, is to be positive about a situation. But she always says that you have to live in the moment, not look too much about how you are and what the future might hold. And she always says, let's try and make positive changes. She has made positive changes to the way there was, I think, the public in Manchester view asylum seekers, about how they can volunteer and what they can do to support asylum seekers.
First chance to vote. So, Oliver Bradley for Natalie Halford and voted, so please pass your buttons on to the next person. And the second round. Are we ready? And four Diane Ngoza. Okay. Now, while they're working out the winner, volunteering is not compulsory. Mandated volunteering. We don't do anything which for our sector. So can I please invite Steve Tandy and Ryan Skillen to announce the my time is so
Volunteer of the Year award is Oliver Bradley.
Next category. Ready? Great. We've never done this one before. Teams, products and energy.
At the moment, within corporate events, our extra support, a diverse range of life experiences and ability to communicate.
So we've given them packs of food out, and it's a choice. Land. 3.5 years ago, we offer food, stone, catching moss. Whoever comes with us and they need something. And so when we just follow them on, they use these to offer a service that's needed.
Who are either coming out, maybe new to man guidance, to service users who offer steam. But we find that attending the group helps service users. Our Wednesday night meetings are often very busy. The volunteer team set up the room for the first time. We deal with requests starting in the room when things are quite quiet. As well as our weekly meetings, the team meet once a month to discuss ongoing group administration, volunteer training, and to plan new projects for the group. We also have an annual training to do and basically make sure that we're meeting the needs of our current service users.
Voting time again. So, first round of voting. To vote for Childline, press 1. To vote for Emily, or to vote for Icebreakers, press 3. So first round, start voting now. Right, that's the first round done. Second round, so pass the buttons on. If you've not voted yet, this is your only chance. Vote now. One for Childline, two for Emily's Pantry, three for Icebreakers. I think that should be about 10 seconds. Right, and while they're calculating the results, we're particularly delighted because Manchester City Council are supporting this award, as increasing volunteering is a key part of the Our Manchester strategy. So please welcome to the stage to announce the winner, the Chair of the Members Voluntary Sector Interest Group, Councillor Mary Watson.
Volunteering Team of the Year is Emmeline's Pantry.
We're trending nationally. Volunteering. So it's important that the organisations they work with, it needs to be supported and nurtured. So this needs resources, it needs money. Charity or community group is the person who looks for me. So can you please welcome to the stage our nominees from Back on Track.
And we've just run our first market jobs, and they've all been brilliant ambassadors of Back on Track.
The identity of the board is that people know what we're about, people know that we're run by volunteers, and our young and it's those young people who want to volunteer for us and be part of our team.
Kind of pride ourselves on creating a family feel, and most of the volunteers have gone through all stages of the club, so they've been here from 8 years old. We're still here, so that pride of being part of the club.
We've got a great website and Twitter and Facebook, but I think us as representatives of Norbrook out there in the community, we got youngsters here at 8 years old, 11, 14, 17, who want.
If you've got an idea, it's listening to, it's understood. Yeah, if you didn't waste your life and everyone's involved in it, I was like to say that we're trying to teach the children. It's like, it gives you that chance to be a role model. you enjoy yourself, you get into the industry. Enjoy yourself so much.
So, to vote for Back on Track, press 1. To vote for Norbrook Youth Club, press 2. And to vote for Reach Out, press 3. So, round 1 of voting, start now, please. For round 1, so we're on to round 2, so again, pass the buttons over, last chance to vote, so press 1 for Back on Track, 2 for Norbrook Youth Club, and 3 for Reach Out. Start now. If you pressed it before I said start now, it won't have registered, so make sure you press the button. Okay, I think we're in. Right, we've got it going.
So, Back on Track.
Back on Track. Thank you for voting for them because their office is directly above mine. I've never heard the end of it. Right, are we ready for the next category?
Come on, guys.
No. Sefton's pressing buttons. Best service user involving organisation. Now, the reason that we picked this one is because this is one of the reasons MAC was founded. As well as involving from a service, should be directly involved in the design and delivery, as they told me. So, I'm the voluntary sector with these folks specifically on involved in the way they run, the person who does so important the voluntary sector does. Three peer ambassadors projects. Okay, next category. Doing all right? No, I'm not. would have said that. I nearly said we're doing all right for time, but we'll go wrong. Right, next category is belief that voluntary community sections, sector organisations have not only the right, but the duty to speak out about what's happening in communities. We seem to have a government which is hostile to the voice of the voluntary sector. Only last week we heard again that government is trying to impose an anti-planning to discussion. I believe there's been a new Cabinet Office announcement about a policy unit for the sector, and I hope it embraces the role of the sector. I do just take part in the EU referendum campaign. I think it would have had a cleaner, better, more honest... Social change in this country has been driven by bridging and cherishing that. We asked nominees to say what the need was and what difference their campaign made. So, can I please invite to the stage the nominees from... Inspire Task Force's Age Friendly Campaign. It's an inspired one. And finally, Yellow Jigsaw for the I'm Not John campaign. And we'll play the film.
Hi, I'm Tom Skinner, and I coordinate the Greater Manchester Living Wage campaign. Our vision is to transform Greater Manchester into a living wage zone. We want living wage pay or higher to become the norm in Greater Manchester, and we want there to be no more in work poverty. We've been amazed with the results. Where we started, there were less than 20 accredited living wage employers. Now there are over 100. The first football club, one of the first councils, one of the first care companies. In all these parts, we now that's what's going to transform the city. We need the whole city to make this work, and what we can use the assets that's out there, whether it's by each other, how about each individual organisation.
We Buy a Centre, campaigning for our area to become more age-friendly. In March, we started the Media Cross Arts campaign and hold the graffiti Grammys. After the first press release, the mirror in the BBC's one show and had articles in numerous online news websites. The drop curb being installed outside the local Shelton housing complex, and we recently heard the whole high street.
I'm not John Mayne, I'm called John, who are chief executives of FTSE 100 companies and there aren't any women. So, positions are taken up by women. The campaign showcased lots of inspirational ideas like presenter Sam Walker. Now come for your boss into billing. So join us on our mission to make sure you don't have to be John to be the boss.
Okay, so, voting time again. Voting round one. To vote for Greater Manchester Living campaign and to vote for the I'm Not John campaign from Yellow Jig. Okay, that's one finish, so pass the buttons along again. You should be getting the hang of this now. And Inspire Task Force 3 for Yellow Jig. Supported by One Manchester Housing Association, so can I please welcome. To take a comfort break. Stretch your legs, grab a drink, and then I'm going to ask you to be back in here for 8:30. It's now 8:20, because we've got some very special entertainment lined up. Please, please make sure you buy raffle tickets, if you've not already done so, because we'll be closing the sale of raffle tickets soon. And anyone not back in their seat in time will be forced to buy more raffle tickets. So, back here for 8:30, please.
Thank you.
2 minutes to take your seats again, please. Thank you. seconds has to buy more raffle tickets. I sound really, really old and out of touch because I can't convincingly talk about words like bassline or urban grime and pull it off and make it sound good. But I'll just say, please welcome to the stage local singer, musician, producer, musical talent, King Burger.
Hello, everyone. Hope you're having a good evening. I'm just here to do a couple of songs for you. That's okay. Oh, yeah.
Is this love that
right. I wanna love ya, hey. Every day and every night we'll be together. Oh, oh, oh. In the cool dance over my head and share the shelter. Yeah. Oh, oh. Up my single bed. We'll share the same room. Yeah, I wanna know, wanna know, wanna know now. I wanna know. So let me know, let me know, let me know now. Yeah. We're in the name of God.
Before we start our next award, I just want to take a couple of minutes to say, make a little announcement. It was an amazingness, I've just made up a word, that's the volunteer community sector in Manchester. Wonderful stories like the ones you're hearing tonight are going on around us all the time. It's like the air. You don't notice it looked after a friends group. If you've been ill, the chances are it's a charity that's helped find the funding to get the cure or the treatment. It's our organisations, our charities, they're organisations that are run for a charitable benefit and are often supported by volunteers. It goes on all the time, all around us, in all our communities, in this country, in the rest of Europe, all around the world. Throughout this week, we've been trying to celebrate by local volunteer community organisations as the Spirit of Manchester Festival. And the point of this is who we are. We're part of the community. Come and see us. Matt's role in this is simply to put a flag down and say, right, we're doing it this week. And then we work with all the organisations around the city to see who's up for doing an international festival. The Spirit of Manchester one doesn't attract all those big sponsors. We do it simply to invite people into our space. If you have a look on the Manchester Community Central website, you'll see details of all of those. It's still going on. We're only on the 6th. It runs up to the 10th. Cycling section, sessions, coffee and cake. Just little things that bring people together. And this year we added in Spirit Story, where we worked with 30 local organisations and asked them to tell us what they did on a single day. Because if you add the power of all those single days together, it's an immense force for good that's taking place in the city. So we had 30 stories, and it was members of the MAT team, volunteers, trustees. We all rang them up and said, right, well, tell us, what did you do today? How many people did you see? So I urge you to have a look at those. And all of this was possible, and I'm going to embarrass three people now, because we've had three fantastic young women working with us at MAC since the summer. We've had interns and trainees working with us. So I'd just like to invite to the stage, and they didn't know I was going to do this, Adele Postins, Anika Jarvid, and Alice Nicholas. Come up to the stage and take a bow, ladies. Where are you? Come on. It's because of these three that we are trending nationally on social media. is because of these three that we've been able to get all those events together and get all those stories sorted. So I just wanted to introduce you to them all. Take a bow, get a photograph. Because these three are at the start of their careers, and we hope that what we've done is show them what is possible. So, and they have been fantastic for us. So I just wanted to say publicly a huge thank you to all three of them. And from all of us, the most you all know. Time for some more awards. So, slightly different approach with this one. This is the award for Best Community Space. Now, new category. This is inspired by the fact that over the last couple of years, we've been helping voluntary community groups in taking on the running of some of the buildings and facilities around the city as part of the work on a project we call Community Asset Transfer. And in the city, which is increasingly defined by a very, very thriving consumer economy and lots of big shiny buildings and everything, these break that. And because these are spaces, we wanted to encourage people to go and see them. You'll see that all the tables today are the names of Manchester parks, and there's a bit of information about them. I don't know about them. Go and have a look at it. I went up to Clayton Park a while ago. I've never been there before. It's fantastic. It's amazing. BMX track there. Brilliant. Anyway. Now, what was this one? We ran an online vote in July, and the nominations in the online vote were, and they're not coming up, Friends of Angel Meadow, Growing in the City, the LGBT Centre run by the Proud Trust, LGBT Foundations Community Resource Centre, and White Moss Club for Young People. So just a huge round of applause for them, because they're all fantastic community spaces. Now, by the end of July, we received over 700 votes. That's not bad for our first online poll. I was really chuffed about that. The runner-up, who can't be with us tonight, unfortunately, was the LGBT Centre. That's the Proud Trust Centre in City Manchester, in Central Manchester. But the winner, that we already know, and it's in your brochure, so this isn't actually a surprise if you've read it. But the winner of the Best Community Space Award 2016, here at last to receive their trophy, was Growing in the City. So can I invite Growing in the City? Where are you guys? Really, really well done for that, because that's the first time we've done that. As an opportunity to show how we can do things differently by working with the spaces. And your voting again is best. Another thing we want to encourage groups to do, the important thing is that by banding together you can be more effective. Good, but don't be tempted to think that we should just bung everything together nations a lot of the time. That's why we're so diverse. That's Nexus Art Cafe Safe Haven. Now over on this side of the room, please. Thank you. And finally,
a massive issue for people being able to access bank accounts, mainly through lack of ID, but also fear of the banks and uncertainty about how bank accounts work. What we've done was we partnered up with South Manchester Credit Union and Job Centre Plus ID. We We supported the customer to explain how the account would work and made sure that working in partnership, we were really able to make an impact. We was able to help 108 customers access bank accounts, and that opened up doors to going into work, getting benefits paid in quicker, and just taking control of the finances, which was a massive step forward.
To grow, develop and be themselves. We're open every day and we focus on community and spiritual engagement.
The Safe Open Project is a collaboration between GMP and Nexus. The sessions run 11 p.m. till 6 a.m. each Saturday, and it's a place where people who are feeling vulnerable during the nighttime economy, for them to come and get help with their situation.
Safe Open offers community a very safe place that we know we can leave people. Crime on the way home due to being intoxicated, recharging batteries of themselves, Norway, and go to other homes and get home safe.
We're a charity based in the Holy Quarter and we partner with universities in the area as well as schools. Our aim is to democratise tuition, so we're basically about trying to get kids in school. So we recruit with our tutors through partnerships, for example, with the University of Manchester, Edinburgh College of Music, and also Manchester Met. Manchester Met, we've also done a big project with them to send some of their students into primary schools in the local area, and then we sort of lived over 1,000 hours of reduced tuition onto their courses through Manchester and wider participation. So we've got some tutors that are going into their old primary schools or their old secondary schools and sort of tutoring kids that were very much like them, didn't have access to tutors, and with that help, hopefully they can go on to similar universities.
For Nexus Art Cafe, and three to vote for the Tutor Trust. Start voting now. That's right, so just repeat your vote. Technical hit, that's not bad, that's the first technical hit at 9 o'clock, that's a record. Cafe and three for Tutor Trust. Okay, this is your last chance to vote, and please start voting now. One for Mind Your Money, two for Nexus Art Cafe, and three for Tutor Trust.
Is it done now?
We're all done. So this award is being supported by Kia Construction. So can you please welcome Maxine Ridley to the stage to announce the winner. Great to see so many tenants of Swan Buildings winning tonight. That's really good. Brilliant. Right, now. Next category is business citizenship, which is a slightly unusual term because it's not just about the private sector. There's an assumption that charities and businesses live in separate worlds. I think we've got to get real about that. At MAC, we want to focus on the charity sector. That's got to be smarter than just saying, please give us about working together. So we want businesses to pay good wages, to support higher standards. By the way, other organisations operate. We can change businesses which are acting as good citizens. Living wage, not the one that the government is now. In welcoming to the stage, the nominees from Contour Homes, Fabulous Fanfare, and Sally Wines. Now, back to respond to an incident. That's an organisation putting people first, right, and we'll come into that. So, well done to them for getting their priorities right tonight.
Of organisations working together. Contour Homes is part of that partnership. We're all working together to create 3,000 residents live in this area, so they're our sort of beneficiaries. The organisation's wanting to close a road and to hold. So we've got a team of three community wardens who work in Brunswick. And what they offer is a real connection to the community. They're out and about or something else. One of the biggest things we also have is a local employment target. So we actually work with our contractors and with the other company in a year's time. I hope we'll be even further ahead with our.
The catering partner at sporting venues. Catering company working at a venue. There's two really different ways that the volunteers go directly to help support the charities.
For whatever emergencies that come up within street soccer academy.
Get some experience, knowledge, skills, and being able for them to be able to build that capacity. They're fantastic.
To know that we're going to have regular income through being here.
So that you only have to do one job and you'll be able to survive doing it. I thought it was a really great scheme. I believe passionately that you should be able to do one job and survive. You shouldn't have to do two or three jobs. So when we opened sort of, we had some new
employers to become living wage employers. Because, well, what does it mean? Sarah in particular, the co-founder of the business, has been conveying positive messages about the living wage, how it can be good for business.
Round one voting, so press 1 to vote for Contour Homes, press 2 to vote for Fabulous Fanfare, and press 3 for Fabulous Franfare. I don't know who Fran is, but apparently she's great. So please pass the buttons along to the next person, and round 2 of voting starts. Now, all the films that you've been watching are on YouTube. So you get to tweet and share. Obviously the groups that have been nominated get a copy of the films. So it's my pleasure to announce that the winner of the 2016 Business Citizenship Award is Fabulous Fanfare. And is Fran coming up to the stage? Award. Manchester's a long way behind the national average when it comes to, but it's improving. We've known for years that voluntary and community groups have a huge role to play in promoting and supporting, but we've made great progress as MAC working with our colleagues in the NHS and in the local authority around wellbeing. Recently, we were able to give out grants from the clinical commissioning about it, because one of the numbers that was in it is how many friendships we, preventative work of local groups that saves the NHS and social care a fortune every year. They need more of us. These nominations are exactly the kind of examples. Icebreakers. And the Old Moat Greenies.
Icebreakers.
people that contribute to all mental health conditions. And they can either be self-referred or they're just finance and assertiveness, and healthy eating. And a big one is like social interaction. We have a very holistic approach to all of the whole personal development. So for all these classes, and I say, which one do you think would you say, what is it you think? Yeah. So the fact that they're, you know, some people are writing like maybe at home, and the fact that they're coming here and interacting and meeting people and getting involved.
I think we find that people are joining us for breakfast. Do so because they feel isolated, alone, and they often just need some support. Where our service users can express themselves, seek information, and seek support from volunteers and other service users. We find this is very important in improving mental well-being and self-confidence of some of our service users who've often spent years, and this helps our service users to feel that they're not alone. We mostly recruit our volunteers from past service users who are familiar with icebreakers themselves, and we find that once they've gone full
not just to be able to plant things, sow seeds and plant things, it also gives me the opportunity to
as much as I wanted to do it, I haven't got a clue where to start. And truthfully speaking, wasn't motivated in it. Because only through the oatmeal green, it's like, I've got my seeds out. And there's no stopping me now.
We should grow something. We should grow something.
A little bit jealous.
Me and the boys. Me and the supporting.
Yeah, we can be family anymore.
So voting for Old Moat Greenies, round one voting starts now. Please, and we'll start round two. Start voting now. So vote for Creative Living Centre, two for Icebreakers, and three for Old Moat, by the Manchester Clinical Commission groups. So can I welcome to the stage Dr. Philip Burns, the chair of South Manchester CSTO.
So it's my pleasure to announce the winner of the Health and Wellbeing Award, which is supported by the three clinical commissioning groups in Manchester. The winner is the Old Moat Greenies.
So this is the last time you're going to vote tonight, and this is the, do we have to be time this? Equalities Award. No, Equalities Award, right. One of the most fundamental things about our centre is to promote equalities and challenge discrimination, written into our DNA. So we ask for nominations of groups and projects and organisations that are working on one or more issues like race, disability, gender, gender identity, sexual orientation, age, faith, other issues for which people experience discrimination. One of the things many people really love about Manchester and the range of communities that we have in this city, but many of our organisations. So, please welcome to the stage the nominees from Awaz Community Radio, the Inspiring Change Manchester Women's Voices Lived Experience Group,
Samikum Namaste Satsakar Shalom, good day. You are a giver voice to the community, especially to those who have had theirs taken away.
with Muslim Women's Network UK, we organised a workshop to tackle the issue of forced marriages.
We have all grown to call ourselves a stepping stone. People build their confidence with God.
The City Council, Greater Manchester Police and many organisations, because we believe that working in partnership makes our community stronger and safer.
Yes, domestic abuse, and some are dealing with mental health issues.
But we believe in giving everyone who steps through our doors an equal opportunity to make a better life for themselves.
Homeless, I self-served. I committed crimes and turned to sex work. I was in prison, not afraid to take my kids away. Isolated, ashamed, powerless. I have no voice, no confidence, no self-stepping out.
We spoke about trauma and abuse in Parliament to MPs, Lords, and the sustainable development of women's direct access. Ensuring residents' voices are listened to and lost on.
The campaign inspired by Stephen Lawrence was a young boy, a young black boy in South East London that was stabbed twice. And I believe that put in a buzz of hope to see another young black boy just like yourself on a platform, speaking out about what they believe, tackling discrimination, racism, as one, as a society, no matter who you are, an injustice thrives within our society.
So press 1 to vote for Elwha's Community Radio, press 2 to vote for the Inspiring Change Manchester Women's Voices Lived Experience Project, and 3 to vote for Retain. Start voting now. 1 for Elwha's, 2 for Inspiring Change, and 3 for Retain. Bob Ferguson to the stage to announce the winner. Where are you up?
I'm pleased to announce the winner of the Equalities Award is...
This is about somebody who embodies the best of the voluntary sector. Somebody who has enthusiasm and creativity and brings people together and all with
which you're going to see in the film.
This is going to be really good, especially if you know and you didn't know this. I'm looking forward to this. But this award, we're delighted, is supported by the University of Manchester. So
okay, thanks Mike. The University of Manchester charity in Manchester, and we're certainly one of the oldest ones as well. Hands up if you're a university student or a graduate of the University of Manchester tonight. But give me a whoop. Yeah? So it's important, we have a big footprint in this city, it's really pleasing to see. And also the role of young people, I think that can sometimes be forgotten. People in schools, people across our great universities who've given up their time for social action. And giving up that time, a real coincidence tonight for me is Majid is from, I believe, the greatest part of Manchester. Wally Range, I'm a bit biased because he's a neighbour of mine, so it's a total coincidence. Going to different meetings, you see him everywhere. And so it's really well deserved, I think, that Majid gets this award. So I believe there's now a video about him. We'll be showing that first before he comes up. And the winner then, okay... And now we'll play the film.
My actual name is Mohammed Majid Dar.
But growing up, I've always used my middle name, and everyone knows me as Majid.
Majid Dar is something that I've known since I was about 14 years old, so the best part of 14, 15 years. And he's always had an eye out for the communities, and the feeling of passion towards other people.
In some respects, I had a very good a local breakdance and body popping crew in the 80s where we used to put on shows and events for the communities and bring people together. We used to train in a religious man. He founded a local mosque, and he was always active in teaching us, for us, you know, to get along with our neighbours, no matter what they were, what color they were. So, you know, the upbringing was great, and I think this was pioneering interfaith, multicultural approach to society before it was.
Majid worked so hard in this community, he doesn't stop. I don't think I've ever known Majid to have a day off work.
School and college days were heavily influenced by introduction of gang culture and lifestyle coming over from due to positive influences and relationships and friends, I managed to realise and achieve my potential. That's the reason I'm passionate about the work I do, is supporting young people from disadvantaged communities all across Manchester. No matter what challenges young people face, if you invest in them, they can overcome any issues. Racism isn't new. I remember my brothers facing groups called the Skinheads, you know, where there used to be a lot of trouble in the communities across the South and Asia. One's an entrepreneur, one's a restaurateur. My sister is a social worker, she's an elected member. She might even be here somewhere in the crowd today. I'm absent. With sacrifice and faith, miracles can happen. Me receiving this award today is a clear example. Nothing short than a modern day miracle. I'd like to thank you all. Thank you very much.
That's the awards done. Thank you all for your votes and your participation and your patience. In that concern, you may have gathered that the raffle has now closed. I don't know if we got it totally. It's fairly fast. So if you win a prize, please stay on your table. And a member of the MAC team who's looking after your table will take your ticket and come and collect it. This time, to take us through the raffle and give you a bit of a break from me, I'm going to pass you over to my deputy, who has consulted all the staff and made up all the gags that they're going to have to issue about me during the event. Preston. Thank you, Mike.
Mike, you're going to be the glamorous assistant, by the way. Stand by the prizes so we can get them out quite quickly. Is that what we're doing? Are we doing that? Anyway, Mike said earlier that there was a bit of a competition within the staff team. It was between Kerry and Alison, who had the green tickets, I believe, and Pauline and Helen, who had the yellow. The winner is... all the way around, I've been told. Yellow, Kerry and Alison. Green, Pauline and Helen. The winners are Kerry and Alison, £477 and 15 pence. Not right, 15 pence. Total of £863 and 15 pence. Thank you very much. Okay. Right. This year, the first prize. Mike's going to pick out the ticket. Oh, good man. Interactive. Who are you going first, Mike? So this first prize is for the paintball voucher. Is that annoying everybody? Right, okay. So this is for 10 people to paint the... whatever. I won't go there. I didn't do it. Have we got a winning ticket, Mike? This was... between the Corbynites and the anti-Corbyn people. Steve Snowman, Jeremy, what have we got?
Yellow 92.
We have a winner over there. There's a gentleman, I believe. Congratulations. The next one is for a VIP drinks voucher for Cafe Nero. We've not worked out why it's VIP. It's four drinks vouchers. And I think the VIP bit is you and your friends can go and use a Cafe Nero on your own. As long as you get there at 6 o'clock, just as they're opening the doors and you rush in. Have we got a ticket? Come on, mate, we need a ticket. Have we got one? Quicker. Come on, Pauline. What have we got? Yellow? 269, yellow 269, gentlemen up here. Well done. 6 a.m. you lot are going for a coffee. Next prize, yellow 269, you're listening, mate. Keep up this. The next one is a £100 voucher, very generous, from Slater's Menswear in Manchester. Now, Mike is actually modelling one of their suits. £89 for a three-piece suit. The finest nylon anybody can buy, and apparently it's guaranteed rain resistant and stain resistant. However, I've seen a few stains on it, so we'll scrub that one. Great price though. Have we got a ticket? Who's got the box? Who's got the box getting tickets? Green 3. What? Sorry, green 143. Whoa, look at that. Three-piece suit, you've got enough money left over for a pair of undercrackers and some socks. What? Mike's suit, see him after. He's modelling the very one. Next, this comes from Mike Wiles, almost legendary DVD collection. Every year he pulls a classic out. So this year we've got Robin of Sherwood, the DVD collection. Robin has been played by some megastars. Yeah, Douglas Fairbanks, Kevin Costner. Unfortunately, there isn't a megastar. I couldn't believe who it is, but it's somebody called Michael. Was it? Michael Praed.
How many ladies were alive in the 80s who remember Michael Praed?
Look at this. Ladies, you like a nice mullet. Okay. Have we got a ticket? Green 132. Green 132. We have a winner. Just like Mendon Mullet. Is this the thing I'm doing? Right, next, we've got a CD. We've got two CDs in a row. So the first one, both from the Bailey sisters, of which it's a member of staff, Karen, who's one as part of the trio. She's over there. Wave, Karen. Have you got a ticket? Do I have to say that? Green 111. Green 111. Over there. Oh, look who it is. Let's do the next one. So this is the second of the Bailey Sisters CDs. Apparently they're not sisters and they don't drink Baileys. That's what I read anyway. We got a ticket, Pauline? Yellow 177. Over there we have a winner. Okay, I'm trying to move this on. So the next one is a complimentary pass for two, Blackpool Sandcastle Water Park. Apparently it is the biggest and only water park in the UK. It even boasts an underwater pool called Wetherspoons. And I went once, this is my bag, and there was a squirrel, and he was swimming up and down on his back. And I said to the lifeguard, "Is that hygienic? Why have you got a squirrel? Why is that squirrel swimming up and down on its back like that?" And he said, "He's keeping his nuts dry." Was that bad? Right, thank you. Move on. Cheers. Have you got a ticket? Yellow 120. Is that Sefton? Fix. No, he's won it anyway. Well done, Sefton. You've got to don those tight trunks again. You know the ones you showed me last week. Okay, next prize. 6 bottles of wine. And this is from the Master Office Supplies. Quality wine, not like last year when we were giving away non-alcoholic wine. Can we have a ticket, please?
Yellow, 139.
Yellow again, 139. Are there any greens in there? Yellow, 139. Yellow, 139. Over this side, does anybody like candles? The next prize is a Yankee candle. Pink Sands Sable Rose flavour. I hate candles because I get wax all over me. Gets on my wig. It's getting worse. Sorry. Ticket, please. Green 146. You've got your suit, you see, and you don't want any wax on it. Brown paper and an iron gets waxed out. Did you know that?
Green 275.
Green 275. Green 275. That lady likes a candle. The price, £50. Must stand there, sense of it. Who's got the box? Is it you, Paul? We've got a winner. Is it over there? Yeah, fantastic. Cheryl's got it there. Some great stalls. Can we have a ticket? Green 207. Green 207. Over the, we've got a one-day happiness training workshop. And I think there's a few people who may need this, including Mike. Apparently it's a way of being happy without using loads of mind-bending illegal drugs. And the winning ticket for that, please, is... Yellow 323. Someone's going to be really happy. They look happy. They don't need it. Hold on. Okay, we're on again. This is from Stagecoach. 10 vouchers for weekly bus travel. 10 vouchers for weekly bus travel. Fantastic if you've got a load of volunteers, obviously. Ticket. Green 57. Green 57. Here you go, gentlemen. I hope he likes going on the Wigan instead of bus. Okay. Nice prize next. We've got a spa day for two at a Marriott hotel of your choice. Skipton Building Society donated this. That's unpleasant. Can we have a ticket? Who's got the box? Yeah, come on. Where is the box? Green 203. Pauline, don't move so quick. I keep losing. I don't know where you're going. Right, okay. 2 standard class train tickets from Virgin Trains. Unfortunately, these are singles, so wherever you go, don't go too far. You've got to roll back. Can we pick this one up, please? Yellow 268. Yellow 268. Wine. And then when I look, there's a bottle of whiskey inside. So that's good. The bad news is that 2 bottles of wine and then 4% volume. For those who don't care about what it tastes like, but they just want to, you know, get to where they want to go, this isn't about prize. Ticket. Yellow 355. Okay, family ticket for 4. Because this is the upgrade. This isn't... And you can have your pictures taken with loads of trophies. How about mine taken with the Wigan Athletic? Green 66. Green 66. Mention Man City again. Sorry. 20 pies. 20 pies, ladies and gentlemen. What a party, you know. And it's... Can we have a ticket? Yellow 4. 10 people on that table. That's a pound each. That's a pasty. Pasty each. We've now got a mug and 2. What's that? Yellow 26. Yellow 26. My colouring in. It's beautiful. It's worth £40. £40. For the unique. And And a colleague of mine said that organic wine, you can drink it, but you don't get a hangover. And it's rubbish. And I have nice platforms and all that. Can we have a ticket, please? We've got a winner. The cleaners. Can we have a ticket? New ticket. She'll drink any wine. So we're going to need Marks and Spencer's toiletry bag. Green, somebody wants it. Admit it. We've got a selection of children's books, again from Maureen Smith, the cleaners. Can we have a ticket, please? Green 283. We're not fixing it, Sefton. He's showing the children's books again. Hey, that's quite new. Yellow. Yellow 33. It's Carol Dyson who actually donated this. It is bling. It is bling night ride. 46. Good event. Are you single? Steve, are you single? Anyway, the point is, Jen has won the mystery prize, which is basically a night in for two. That's what I'm saying. So if you are single, just pick your man here because you've got that box. That is a winner. But I expect she wouldn't be. She doesn't do well. Sorry, a little classic. And then she gets a bottle. Well done. Right? You know, we've had competitions in the office. Seeing how pull off a beard like that. He's the only male member of staff.
Very, very quickly. What we're going to bid us. Now, I'm not casting aspersions on anyone in the room, but we've done this before and treated it in accordance with protection. Don't worry. Right, first, who's going to give me 50 to start with? One there. Any advance on 50? Remember, all this is going to the Spirit of Manchester Fund. If you wanted to, you can buy this with the next guy. 60? He'll give me 70. Anyone give an answer on 70? I'm going up to 75. Can somebody give me 75 for them? Thank you very much. 85? Can I get 85? 90. Will anyone go as far as 90? Can we go into treble? 100! Thank you! Brilliant! Thank you very much. That's why I answered. 46 the gap goes. So really. Match day tickets for like, some merchandise, so it's two shirts. Sure. We'll want this. Take your rivalry to its full extent. Who will give me 80 to start us off? 85 over there, not sure. Any advice? Did we have one over here? No? 115. Thank you, Johnny. Anyone else? 115, come on. 120, 135, anyone? 150, any more? Last, it was an inch. We keep going a bit longer, 165, too much. Any advance on 200? 210? Oh, this is fantastic. Did anybody want a top 250? A late edition will personally provide afternoon tea for 10 people in the loop. Now, if I get the team head, I'm going to start at 100. Did I see? Which way am I going? 110? This is 200. I think there's some delegated authority being negotiated on certain parts of the room. It's got spot. 220. 240? Are we sticking on 240? Did you not want to step in? No? No? Are you stepping in? So 250? Oh, 250. This is an audience with the Lord Mayor. 300! That's nice. 300. Last call, 300. 300, going once, 310, 320, anyone? Are we sticking at 310? Once, 3:30. Once, I'm going to keep doing it. Twice, 350. Wow. Completely unplanned, thank you, Lord Mayor. 350. Last call. Once. Last call. 360. Once. 400. £400. Twice. Sold. £400. Thank you so much. And thank you to the Lord Mayor for stepping in. You two need to meet each other. Thank you. That is wonderful. I'd like to local volunteer community groups in the next few months. It's 10 o'clock. I'd expected to start this bit at 10 o'clock, so thank you, everybody, for getting us through the evening so quickly. I want to thank the Sheridan Suite, who did such a fantastic job. It was their idea to put the colours from the Spirit of Manchester logo on the back of the tables. I'd like to thank our team of filmmakers. I'd like to thank everybody who nominated, voted, persuaded somebody else to vote, who walked up on stage and didn't fall over because this is a bit slippy. I would particularly like to thank my wonderful Mac colleagues who have put so much work into this event tonight. Honestly, these people are out and I'm going to get to the last minute message now, am I? Has anybody got a voting button in their pocket? It's somewhere over there. If we can just have a look for it, because they are, you know, quite expensive to replace. They're getting us through, and Martin, with all the technical stuff, that is not an easy job trying to get all that sorted. And above all, thank you for coming, and thank you to do this again next year, and I hope you'll come and join us. Have a safe journey home, and good night. Voting button.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.